Hey guys, so you guys probably know that a lot of my videos on this channel are the videos where I read the Bible or hear it being read from my computer, so the narrator reads the Bible for me, and I respond to it as an atheist. You know, I give my perspective on it, on what was said in the Bible. And so, you know, I've been getting an interesting amount of responses, if I do get responses on those kind of videos, mainly videos that do not agree, you know, mainly from Christians, who are like, oh my gosh, you know, this is why, like, I believe what you're saying is not right, whatever. So, anyway, what the interesting thing that happened that recently is I got a personal message from a YouTube user, and it was just kind of like, hey, so are you really an atheist? I was like, it was an interesting PM to get, so I responded, like, yes, I am, like, you couldn't tell from my videos, and then I got a response back, like, you know, I need to watch, like, a couple of your videos, but, like, okay, so, like, do you mind talking about that? I was like, no. I responded back, emailed back, like, no, I don't mind, but, like, it's a big topic, like, where do you want to begin? And so the person gave me a place to begin after that. The place to begin, I think, was, trying to remember, I'll look it up actually. So, oh yeah, so I got a response back saying, let's start with meaning. What it means to be human. How did we come to be? So that's the first thing that we talked. And I think this video, I'm just gonna share my response to that, and then call it a day for this video. So I'm just gonna read what I wrote to that person, and see what you guys think about that. I definitely know what he thinks about it because he responded back to this. But I'm just going to share this publicly because I thought it was interesting. Maybe, you know, this is how I respond to that. And I feel like at this point, like, I stick by this. You know, I think this is something I'll stick by. But, yeah, this is my response. It starts, huh, that's an interesting place to start. Well, how we came to be, science, especially recently, has come to show us that we are a product of volatile nothing. There used to be no space, no time, no physical matter. The world was nothing but dark matter. But the craziness of quantum physics is that nothing is not technically nothing. And I know this is something that was said by Lawrence Krauss. Anyway, we now know that 70% of the known universe is composed of dark matter / antimatter, which are stuff that we can't see and stuff we don't yet understand how it impacts the universe. We know that it does impact the universe, and there's more energy within dark matter than within the matter that are visible and tangible. So this metro card would be matter that is visible and tangible, but dark matter we don't see, we can't touch it, but it exists and has more energy and mass, or not mass, but more energy than this metro card. That's what we know from scientific findings so far. In any case, from such quantic nothingness and volatility, the Big Bang occurred, an implosion and explosion so grand that the universe no longer contained only dark matter. The universe began to have time, and with that began to have space. The universe kept expanding, and it is expanding to this day at an ever more accelerating rate. In fact, the expansion of Andromeda Galaxy is closely approaching the Milky Way Galaxy, in which case we'll all be imploded back into nothingness. Nothingness as the overall universe expands. This is, you know, my scientific knowledge is really not that great, but this is, like, I think this is kind of like the basic stuff that has been recently been discovered about, you know, in astrophysics, in cosmology, and things like that. Anywho, out of countless amount of black holes, billions and trillions and gajillions of them, one of them resulted in the solar system we live in. And in this environment, life evolved from a single cell organism to all the different kinds of life we see today, including us humans. That, in a nutshell, is how we came to be. Science is still trying to figure out the details of how non-living matter came to be life, and how the Big Bang originated, and if it actually is the very first Big Bang. But even so, at this point, there's no denying that Big Bang is what resulted in this universe that we live in. And there's no denying that evolution beyond natural selection is a valid scientific theory. A theory that actually has more evidence and proof than the theory of gravity and the theory of relativity. Now, as for this question of meaning, what it means to be human, I think it's up to each and every one of us to figure that out for ourselves. We can be the ones to make the meaning for ourselves. Instead of being a plaything to a vengeful and sadistic gods, it could be a god or gods. But in his case, it would be a god because he's Christian. Anyway, our meaning isn't about dodging, also known as being rescued from, eternal hell of torment. And it isn't about preparing to be a bond slave in heaven. Because if that's the case, then life is unbearably trivial. And more than that, then life has been designed to be unfair from the get-go. Religions think they have the better answer to the meaning of life. But the way I look at it, what religion offers as meaning of being human is being worthless in the eyes of all powerful beings. Whether we end up in heaven or in hell, whether we end up in heaven or in hell, what meaning is there if that meaning is dictated to you and to me that you're not allowed to figure out yourself? Personally, I think being human is an incredible thing. I mean, do you realize what the chances are of being alive in a universe so fucking hostile to life, let alone ending up as a human being? We are so incredibly lucky just to be alive right now. Also, because we arose from the dark matters of the universe like everything else, that also means human beings are fundamentally connected to everything else in the universe. Nature isn't just beautiful and calming. It's a part of us. We're a part of nature. We're important to each other, and we are important to the universe that we live in. So I treat my life like it's a precious thing. It's the only life I have after this is done. And I also see other people's lives and other animals' lives as being precious. And that's part of why my passion is a social work, working towards social justice. And that's why also every day I try to be vegan as much as possible. And also I say at the end, so that's my response so far. I hope this is a good beginning point of answering your curiosity. So he did respond to that, and it's an interesting response that I got. I responded back, he responded back, I responded back. Now, I don't know at which point the response they're in, but like that's been kind of my response so far. If I'm to critique my response, as I'm off like to do, I do admit like my vague summary of the Big Bang Theory is very general. Like the scientific details of that, I'm not qualified to get into. But like that's generally what is achieved by the consensus of astrophysicists. There is some debate about that whole thing about dark matter. Whether the universe is open, closed, parallel, open, closed, flat, Lawrence Krauss argues that universe is flat, and that's how we get the age of the universe to be 13.74 billion years. And I'll talk more about this in the next video, in which I talk about me reading the book A Universe from Nothing, which is by Lawrence Krauss. It's a lot of the stuff I'm just like, whoa, it just goes way over my head. Because science has never been a strong suit of mine. But it's definitely interesting. I start with that kind of general summary. And also, I think another critique, I guess, I'm talking about, like, evolution. Like, it's a fact. It is a fact, pretty much. It is a theory that is more proven than gravity. But I'm saying this to someone who's Christian who doesn't believe evolution to be true. I didn't want to make the message too long, but, like, it's... To someone who doesn't see evolution as a factual thing, it's just like, it must have just kind of just went over their head, like, okay, like, that's your explanation for how life came to be. The response that I got, of course, was just like, you know, like, well, you know, evolution is not true, blah, 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 like, here's like how, like, there's no evidence of a missing link fossil, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Gosh, how many times do you have to hear that? That's a done, dead argument at this point. Many Christians don't realize that. But anyway, the science aspect, I guess, you know, because I didn't go into any detail, that's my critique of what I wrote there. I think I got a lot of flack, I think, for saying, not a lot of flack, but like the response I get, like it's not surprising regarding like, how I say, like, life is such a precious thing. I say in this message, you know, we're so incredibly lucky just to be alive right now. And of course, that, you know, to a Christian, you know, that's something that they can agree with. You know, we are lucky to be alive. But our perspective is different. Because, you know, as an atheist, our life ultimately, if we go back and forth, it's all due to chance, you know? But to Christian, it's God's gift. That's why we're lucky to be alive. And so my response to his response ended up being talking about why I don't think life is a gift. No way. God, anyway, so maybe I'll do another video in which I talk about my second response. But this was my first response to just talking about how we became humans and what meaning is there in becoming humans. And personally, this is my meaning. You know, I think the meaning of being human is open really to anyone. You know, everyone has different meaning of being human. And it's certainly true if you're a Christian, if you are a Christian. And of course, the meaning of being human means, means being a love object of a being that we can't see, that is outside time and space, that apparently made a version of itself to die on the cross so that we could be rescued from the original sin of Adam and Eve, and so to end up in heaven and hell. That's like the meaning of life is to prepare. For a Christian, generally, the basic line is meaning of being human is preparing to go to heaven, to be with God again. It's the meaning of being human for a Christian. I don't know. It's a meaning I used to believe in, but it's just like, looking at it now, it's so utterly ridiculous. But anyway, enough me talking, but that's just been my first response. Any response you have would be cool to share. If you want to hit me another PM, like just like this guy, and ask me a question too, I'm happy to answer. And if it was interesting, you know, I would like to also share it in video form as well. But yeah, take care.